Good afternoon, everybody. You can hear me. It's a brand identity and customer experience what sounds the clock in this conference until now. Even to the point that John here is losing his confidence as an enterprise architect. Because the question is, what about the third big idea of the Book of Milan? Architecture. What about the intersection of the identity and experience and architecture? I didn't dare to put my current title on the slide. I changed it into enterprise designer. but I must have put a stop to it. I dare to state, I must take the stand. I'm an enterprise architect. Yes, I'm transforming to an enterprise designer. But I have not made the step of Nick Gall to the design camp. Who else here dares to state that he is an enterprise architect? Okay, thank you. I feel a little bit more confident now. Olly Shaw was stating, how do I cope with the stovepipes that exist in the architecture? And therefore, I like to put architecture, the third big idea, and this intersection with the other three, in the center of attention now. And I'll make it more explicit even. So I also don't choose for the focus on the customer. Fuck the customer. Let's create a balance. So I'll hang right, you all hang left. And then it's more even. I would like to focus on another tribe, if I take the term stated. And that's the employees and its partners. And I did that in the airline business. And so I focus on the airline operations. Not on selling tickets or something. All customer sales stuff and not that interesting. The more interesting domain is flying aircrafts. Being a crew on board, being a cockpit on board, maintaining aircrafts, operating aircrafts from an airfield, putting luggage on board, etc., etc. That's what airline operations is. And that focus for employees, not the customer part, is also what I did last time in my presentation. Let's see how I operated. Then I had a story about Trivento and how I helped change the company, which I co-own, into a great workplace, a great place to work, business to employee focused. What we created was a cellular organization, having all kinds of cells, so we are with 80. And three of us are Trivento Spark, and well, I would have said that we are an enterprise design, strategic design corporation, but now I must state we are an enterprise architect company of three. Joost is here as well, Joost Lommers. I'm Rijk van Vulpen. The other one is Ruud. And that's what we are focused on. We are creating great workplaces, B2E focused, not B2C focused. So that might make it different. And we also do that for customers. And in this case, I will like to tell the story about Transavia, which is an airline. And I'll start off with an enterprise architect challenge then as well. So my design challenge I got there, because I was hired there, is rationalize our operation. So we are not in the transformation or the incubation area in which every other talk until now was. Sorry, I'm in the performance and productivity area given this design challenge. I'm not disrupting or differentiating the company, mission critical, but I'm in the context, as Jeffrey Moore states it, which means sustaining business, getting the performance out and productivity. And then you say, yeah, we don't like this talk because we would like it to have on the disruption side. Well, I hope to come there. but I have to start at performance and productivity. And I'll tell you from an enterprise architect's perspective, so designers, this might help. If you don't get traction for your disruptive ideas, it might come because all resources, all funding, is taken up by the performance and productivity area. So I hope we can work together because I can help. I can help in that performance and productivity area. I can release resources. I can release funding, and I hope, that will help you. Okay, I'll try to be an enterprise designer. So let me have a little piece of the disruption part as well, because I like the right brain as well. I'll do the left brain for you, but please give me then a piece of the puzzle on the right brain as well. I don't know whether you know the model of Geoffrey Moore, but maybe I'll explain a little. In innovation, there are four areas identified by him. Let's say the non-mission critical parts and the mission critical parts, and core, disruptive, and context. I've mingled some of his different of his matrices. I put all kinds of words there, but there is an incubation area, non-mission critical. That's finding out, look for the long term, new ventures, new possibilities, new capabilities. Then you scale them up to transformation. So you go up there from event to scale up. Then you get at the transformation, and that's digital transformation. That's where the most talks were about the rest of this day. And if you've done that, and that capability becomes non-differentiating, then you could go to performance area. So it's deployed, standardized, rationalized, and then you get at the performance area. And finally, if you say, well, it's not something we should do ourselves, you could offload it either by business process outsourcing or getting rid of applications or whatever. And then you get resources again back to for incubation or transformation pieces. I haven't been doing this effort alone, so I had lots of designers and brand identity types around me. So much of these slides are even made there by them. So I admit this is not completely my effort, but I have had a lot of say in it. And this is something from the book of Milan. But he especially identified the three big ideas types. He didn't identify the entrepreneur or the change agents. And those two, for me, are really essential. So I'm not that capable of changing a company. Within Transavia, there are four people who really made this all possible, and without them, we had not been anywhere. Which one of is the chief commercial officer, and three, let's say, high potential digital program management type people, which I call entrepreneur and change agents. Those are essential to get something like this done. So again, it's not my accomplishment, it's of a complete team. Then somewhat on Transavia. Transavia is a daughter of Air France KLM, the low-cost carrier daughter. But we are not so much focused on low-cost only. We state we are low-cost with care. We come from a history of flying, especially to holiday locations that you can see in the area, especially Spain and Greece and etc. But we need to transform, and are doing that. We are changing from a chartered company to more scheduled services, and from a complex scheduled services company into point-to-point flying services. You might know flying is growing. So we are growing fast. We have invested a company in France, I think 3 years ago or something, who already now has 20 aircrafts and growing, and three bases, etc. And we just launched a base in Munich last February, and already it has something like 7 airplanes. So the airline business is a really fast-growing business. However, you don't earn a penny, so that's quite a problem. What do I need to tell more about Transavia? It's pretty much it. Well, I started there at the beginning of 2014, and this is what I found there. So airlining is a highly regulated business. It has very low margins, at least if you're not an EasyJet or something. It's a very people business, so it's hospitality especially. And of course it's also an operational flight, but okay. What I found in the company was a lot of paper and traditional IT. And also it's a very capital intensive business, so assets heavy as a business model. Yeah, okay, there I am as an enterprise designer or as an enterprise architect. So doing something in IT, well, no digital, people business. I thought, what am I beginning on? Including that design challenge, so rationalize the operation. This is how the cockpit looked at that time. Do you see? Yeah, it's we are flying with 737 aircrafts. Those are not changed very much, because then pilots need to be retrained, so that's not that smart to do. It's backlight in all over in the, so every switch is a backlight, the steering wheel is backlight, and you see a lot of paper in the cockpit. So digitalization is not there. And this is typical for the rest of the airline business as well. So data is communicated through telex formats in this time, for example, and all kinds of things there. So I asked the question, although it's a highly regulated business, are they though willing to disrupt? They are not making much money, though are they willing to invest? They are in a people business, though are they willing to digitize? They have lots of paper and traditional ID, but are they going to innovate? And they have an asset-heavy business model, but would they be willing to re-strategize or take on another business model? Because that's what's happening. Having had that design challenge, I also put myself with some of the entrepreneurs that were there already, a big hairy goal, something like, if we look at the operations business, something should be possible related to having a team-based organization, operating a flight, not hierarchical, not through an operations control and standardized process, but a more team-based a collaboration, or building an ecosystem, at least with the partners and employees, and of course also passengers and customers, but let's focus on the partners and employees for now. Because, for example, there are, I think, to get the logistics of a flight operation okay, there might be thousands of reasons why it shouldn't go okay. For example, the fueler could not be there when the aircraft just has landed, and he must fuel the airplane because we want to be within, let's say, 35 minutes in the air again. The cleaners could not be there. The passengers, well, security lines and all, that could take some time. Get the luggage off and on again. But also, we need a slot to, again, get up in the air. That's something you have, but you can lose And then you have to request a new one, and maybe that's only after 45 minutes available again. There could be bad weather. Well, all sorts of reasons why this operation could completely get ruined. If we could create a team collaboration, socially collaborative, wouldn't it be possible to really change the operations model of the company? So that was what we as an entrepreneur and I had in mind. That's what we aimed for. Yeah, the difficulty was we were in the productivity zone. So we were not at transformation. So okay, let's see where we get. Thank you, Nick and IBM. We had a great 9060 technology at the center of our application landscape, and that is what my productivity area was. What you see here is the application Flash, custom made on that great IBM technology. You see here, what's special about this application is that it contains all data. So you see flights, you see pax, passengers, number of passengers, you see fuel, so the amount of fuel that's in there, but all kinds of other integration and data model filling is only available in Flash, and that's in the heart of the application landscape. It contains 20 plus integrations at that moment in time, and actually it's blocking any transformation that we can do. So we have to tackle this, and management is saying it's impossible to get rid of this. This will be there for the next coming 25 years as well. This blocks us to become a digital company. We managed in something like 9 months to set an effort, working every 2 weeks, removing integrations, removing menu items, etc., etc., or relocating them to other applications, and finally got us this menu item. This is now summer 2017. Many menu items disconnected. This is a real menu item, only having 5 of them still available. And we hope before summer to disentangle them. And this will release really a big amount of resources and budget. Well, great. This brought us to we can start thinking of some innovation. And so we got into the incubation area. And luckily at that time, it was January 2015, Transavia was also re-strategizing, focusing or starting with the identity. And they got to this identity. I've got a feeling I wanna go away. Are you gonna join me? Well, are we gonna Saturday? I've got my suitcase. Together we can work and play. So let's do this. Let's go out and fly away. If you want to, it's really gonna happen. We believe in two, the city of our dreams. It's a pleasure. Inspiration to work with, and we tried to translate just for minimal viable products, just for experimenting, to do little steps to invest in what the future could be given this. These are some examples. So one of the things we had to focus on was bringing platforms in, and we have brought into the cabin a tablet for the stewardesses. With at least an application to perform sales on board as a step. We brought an AirFi box on board, which is a Wi-Fi box, such as a platform such that they, as a team, could at least start working as four stewardesses. Next step, maybe entertainment or passenger getting on that Wi-Fi, such that they could socially collaborate with the stewardesses. And what we, for example, also did as a minimal viable product is a Say Cheese app you see here, related to the passenger experience, of course, with which we could, from a marketing perspective, collect email addresses, etc., because we asked them if we could make a photograph with them, cabin crew, with passengers, to send it home as an extra experience when they got home. So these were tiny, small experiments, not cohesive, but directing to the future using a lean startup process. And that, of course, I got the setback. It was very nice to do some small experiments, but we needed to go to the performance area again, or at least we did tackle the productivity area, and we had to go to the performance area, because Transavia did still have 360 applications that I run with, and very complex business processes. So what we then did, and that's, I think, what an enterprise architect facilitates, is did all kinds of business information planning during a half year. So working from the business strategy down through principles, architecture, and defining gaps, defining blueprints of future states of applications we needed to go to, and both working first from a customer and business focused to the technology infrastructure focus. For example, define a cloud strategy related to technology infrastructure. For example, an application rationalization roadmap from 360 application to 40 application back, and a whole program to realize that. And that's also what we created. So we created a core systems blueprint and roadmap. And yeah, maybe you ask as a designer, what do I have to do with that? Well, as I said, if you have to work with stovepipes and you have to work with processes that are not good aligned, there is no possibility that you, with your one vision or your identity, can realize that. And realization engineering is also part of this puzzle that we as need as an intersection between three things. If we leave this out, and on a single touch point you don't deliver on the identity, I think the complete identity has been lost at that moment. So you need the enterprise architecture to make this this happen. Well, okay, we got that out of the way, and finally we got to an area of transformation, and not only digital transformation, but also operations, company, business transformation. Of course, I only work related to employees or partners, not to customers. So having that new identity, mostly related or translated to customers, you have to rethink, what does this mean in the cabin? What does this mean if you operationalize this new identity of Transavia? And that was not immediately clear. You had to make a translation for that. So what we did was, to do that, for example, created some films to make that apparent. And one of them, in Dutch here, is The Power of Kindness. And I hope you can feel the emotion and what we brought to the cabin in it.
If you walk with me, I walk with you. When you smile, I did something right.
Het zit in ons allemaal. En door het te delen, krijg je er alleen maar meer van. Vriendelijkheid. Bij Transavia merken we elke dag hoe ver je daarmee komt. Welkom bij Transavia.
Dit is vriendelijkheid of gezelligheid is in Nederland ook een... gezelligheid is in Holland also a known term. This is a first try to translate, and this is of course identity, so we recognize that all as designers. Next step, what we did, was try to find a vision, which we called the digital people vision, related to business to employee. So what would we like to deliver for the people working at Transavia to empower them and deliver on them? And we have created three pillars on that. We have created happy people with three focus areas. Autonomy, so putting them in an information position, or at least in putting them in their own power to be able to deliver on the services that customers want. Empower them in personal growth and delivering on the team effort. And that's the vision I already talked about, collaboration and support. So say, make teams of people such that they can deliver agilely. Of course, the passenger and the customer are also inside, but from a perspective to deliver the service to them. And that means real-time contextual knowledge, knowing the differentiation of passengers, because currently in the cabin we are blind. We don't know which passenger is, and we must cater for that. And also work on service, and especially service recovery. Because if you have 1,000 reasons of delay, it's essential that you are capable of delivering on service recovery. And a third part, which states efficient processes, and that's especially about decision making, scenario analysis, effectiveness, and also continuous improvement organization and continuous improvement support. So these are, somewhat of the grand design we created on this. And we did this with much more detail and together with cabin and cockpit and technical services crew. But I don't tell you, will tell you about that. Some of that is, of course, confidential and Transavia specific. What we learned after that is that we didn't know so much about how we scored on these targets, and we created starting points for that. Also on working on the emotional side of things and getting the first employee experience index information. And we started collecting that by starting an employee experience measuring operations. So these were the pillars in the organization in which you could score on specific aspects. Of course, we did a complete employee journey effort related to the emotional part of it, but also the functional part of it. Where do you need extra support? What would really empower you through the complete journey from your home, through the airport, at the airport, through in-flight, and to at the turnaround and at home again? Many details there. I do not share them in this session with you. And then I go to the enterprise architect part of me again, because great designs, etc. But the difficulty is eventually in the engineering and in the really realizing on this quite integral vision in the process. So we have to bringing new support there, both in portfolio management, so saying what has priority on that side, but also bringing in our version of a skilled agile framework, which we named TAF, Transavia Agile Framework, and from which you see some drawings here, but you can compare with skilled agile framework if you know of that. And that's also quite a change. So we trained product owners and Epix owners and quite some operation in a half year to do. But without this, we wouldn't have been having the capability to start delivering on this digital transformation. Well, and then what did we come up with? What were we going to deliver? So we have that tablet in the cabin, but what kind of functionality must you think of? What were the epics that were prioritized? And we have been focusing on the last 48 hours just before to just after the flight. Well, you can think of these kinds of functionalities. So bring a seat map on the tablet. And in that seat map, you have all kinds of customer information or passenger information in detail, both, for example, social, so what have they been tweeting in the last minutes before the flight, but also on an emotional level. So are we capable of knowing what the sphere is on board, what the special service requests are that they have been stating? Have they been in contact with customer service lately? Have they had any problems in the digital process for checking in, for example, et cetera, for going through security, for putting their luggage where they need it? Well, that, so, and you can zoom into a chair, but for example, you also constantly know your scorecard. Where are we at? Similarly, for the turnaround process, so what we have said is you don't only fly any cabin, but you work in the turnaround process as well. What we delivered there was making a team operation in which everybody checks in, and that includes also partners. So, for example, one of the things we don't do ourselves is the ground services, fueling, baggage handling, passenger handling, etc., etc. And more and more of that services will be offloaded. Those are not differentiating, so we offload them. But to deliver on an integrated experience, we still need those people. We need to have the fueler on board, we have to know the handlers, we even have to have customer service personnel and ground personnel at the other destination. In the 360 flight view, collaborating and having one shared Gantt chart of the progress of the turnaround to have it from, let's say, 15 minutes back to 35 minutes. If that's possible, knowing from all team members what their progress is, if they are having trouble somewhere, that will delay the flight, and try as a team to prevent that from happening. In this, also passengers are involved, because we can easily notify them or ask, we are still missing 7 passengers, you are probably somewhere at the airport, please report on this team environment, and well, they get it at their phone, of course, such that we have an integral view of will we make it or not, and what will happen by it. Similarly, we also know that, for example, a sentiment on board here, and we know of problems ahead. So there is in Barcelona, there is a broken equipment related to the handling of the luggage. So we'll probably have to anticipate that and think of a solution there. And similarly, for deviations. So currently there is an operations control available, and it manages centrally the whole operations of Transavia. But if you have a team collaboration effort, that can change as well. And for that, for example, we have been figuring out all kinds of epics related to the airplane communicating ahead, for example, technical issues it is experiencing, being proactive on that to anticipate, but also creating a decision framework for cabin cockpit and the whole team, to be able to decide in certain situations which of a scenario we could choose. So, for example, if there is fog in Amsterdam, it will probably also be in Rotterdam, and we have to deviate to Brussels Airport. Well, if that's the case, we have three possible scenarios. Well, or we could go to another airport like Groningen. What do we choose? Do we choose Groningen? Do we choose Brussels? And which of the scenarios for handling passengers will we do? Will we bring them by bus to Schiphol back, et cetera, et cetera. Also, we could automate all kinds of processes. So we, for example, could notify home stayers because they will drive to Schiphol to get their the passengers by car. Well, they don't need to go, so we can notify them. We can rent cars. We can rebook people. Well, all those things are capabilities we are bringing in place. Well, last thing I would like to anticipate as an enterprise architect, because you as designers know most of the times it would be nice if you have better materials to design with. And that's similar what we also need. So we need new digital materials, we need new platforms to be able to deliver on these functionalities and capabilities. In this case, for example, a platform for engagement of a platform for interaction of analytics. And we have been selecting that to anticipate the delivery of all functionality we need. Well, to conclude, we have lots of lessons learned related to our Digital People program. First of all, a people's vision is key and central in thinking, the three pillars we have been stating. I already mentioned the role of the entrepreneur or the change agent. Without such a person with a vision on the intersection of design, experience and architecture, you will never deliver on such a program, because it will be very one-dimensional, or there is no change effort enough to deliver. You need to free up resources from the performance and productivity zone. If you don't do that, there will not be enough resources to deliver on the transformation. Build resources fast and incrementally to create value and energy. We implemented a skilled agile framework kind of process for that, and that's also something you need. Bring in new digital materials and platforms. And last but not least, together with the entrepreneur and change agents, be a bridge build, but also challenged constantly, because otherwise the level of ambition will fade away fast. And to deliver really on the digital transformation you want, you really have to keep everybody at the point of their seat. Thank you very much for now. This is MI, so if you want to contact me, rijk.van.vulpen@trivento.nl look at us at Twitter or at our site, triventospark.nl. Thank you very much.